welcome back to the channel. Today, I'm going to be telling you guys why I'm quitting FedEx, why I started with FedEx, and what's next. So take a ride with me as I go on my last trip from Pontiac Springs, Florida to Jacksonville, Florida and back. So if you guys follow my channel, you know that I've always wanted to be a truck driver, and the ultimate goal was becoming an operator. I did 20 years in the Army, which was just a pit stop. Now that I'm retired, it's time to follow up on my dreams. So let's talk about the history a little bit of how I even started working for FedEx Ground. Back in 2017, I purchased a truck and leased it on with a carrier. At the time, I did not have the formal experience to drive the truck for myself for that particular carrier. And also during that time, I was still in the Army. My original thoughts were to maybe do something on the weekends or something like that. I ended up leasing the truck onto a carrier and putting a driver in it, and actually did all right for a little bit. Unfortunately, I made the mistake of purchasing a truck that had the EGR bypassed, and it was bypassed incorrectly. So, a couple months down the road, the truck needed a complete rebuild. And at the time, I didn't have enough capital saved up to do that rebuild myself. My mentor at the time made a deal with me, and he actually rebuilt the engine, and the deal was that I would just pretty much let him run the truck to make his money back, and then once I retired, I would get the money for the truck back from him. But unfortunately, that truck was involved in an accident and was totaled out, so that plan kind of went out the window. Anyways, during that year, 2017, I was actually paying truck payment on that truck, and the money that I was making was covering the payment on that truck, which was fine because I was in the Army, so I was not relying on the income. But once the truck was no longer bringing in any revenue, I had to find other means to make the truck payment on that truck and to start gaining the experience needed to be able to drive a truck myself for that particular carrier in the future. And so I started looking around and decided to walk into FedEx Ground one day and talk to some contractors, and went from there. So it was Thanksgiving weekend, November 2017, when I started my training on my right seat ride at FedEx Ground. And by the next week, I was on my own. Initially, it was only supposed to be part-time because I was still active duty in the Army, but eventually, because of the way my schedule worked out, I was able to actually run more full-time. At one point, I was actually driving more miles than the full-time guys. It was a lot of fun. It was pretty tough. Didn't get very much sleep, on average 4 or 5 hours a day, but I was pretty motivated. One, because I had to get rid of some debt, and then two, because I was trying to gain the experience necessary to drive a truck myself and save up for purchasing another truck. And this was in the North Carolina area. Great contractor up there. The route that he had wasn't that great, but I ran Wildman, so I made it work. Fast forward, get stationed back in Florida, and started working for a contractor down in Florida. Also, super great contractor. If you're ever looking for a trucking job in the Northwest Florida area, then I would definitely give this guy a call. Joey Moore Trucking out of the Pontiac Springs, Pensacola, Florida. So I started driving for this particular contractor down in Florida back in October-ish 2019. Did that for a little bit, and then I deployed to Afghanistan in early 2020. And so then when I came back later that year, August time frame, I picked back up and started working for him again in September of 2020. And pretty much did that until I retired from the Army in November of 2022. Really good routes, made some really decent money, awesome contractor to work for. So he had a truck, a 2007 Freightliner Columbia, that needed an overhaul. And so I worked out a deal with him, and I obtained that 2007 Columbia from him and decided to get the truck overhauled. So here, I dropped the truck off in January, or had the truck picked up in January and towed to Jacksonville, Florida. There's a guy there who specializes in Detroit 60 overhauls and been doing it for 30 or 40 years and can literally overhaul an engine in a weekend. And he came highly recommended. So I had the truck towed there in January. Around January 20th. Ordered the overhaul kit through Freightliner. Overhaul kit came in, but unfortunately they accidentally sold it to someone else. So then I had to wait around another 2 or 3 weeks for an overhaul kit to come in. So a new overhaul kit finally came in, and mechanic got to work on doing the overhaul. And then they were just kind of like problem after problem, issue after issue, things that were just happening. And I would say from when I dropped the truck off in January until now we're in June, I put in my application with this particular carrier in December, and I pretty much had to keep renewing things, whether it was like updating a job status or, you know, updating this, updating that. Finally, 3 weeks ago, everything like it was good to go. Did my drug test, did my inspection on the truck, and it was time to go. Then, of course, one more issue came off the truck that had to get addressed. So now that everything is working and good to go, it's time for me to hit the road. Anybody guess where I'm going to be going? Yep, you guessed it. Landstar. Landstar is the company that I will be pulling loads for. I'll actually be heading to orientation this week. I'll be posting that video later. You guys stay tuned for that. And I'm going to actually start posting videos on my journey to become an owner operator. And hopefully, eventually, fleet owner. So that's the plan. I know right now is a really rough time to get into the industry as an owner-operator. But I think that I'll be okay. I think I have a pretty decent business plan. And I have other sources of income, which means that I can pay myself less than most other owner-operators can pay themselves in order to survive. So fuel rates are high and freight rates are down, but if I can make it in this market, then I can make it in any market. It would have been nice to have gotten a chance to take advantage of how good the market was a few months ago, but that didn't happen. So it is what it is.
If a load was illegal, they'd call on the Eagle. That trucker'd been cheating for years. He lived on back highways and unpatrolled byways with only his conscience to hear. He made his first run at the age 21 with a load of bootleg alcohol. Well, his time is near done, 'cause he's planned his last run with the biggest payload of them all. He's an old gear jammer, putting down his last hammer, headed straight for that slammer or a hole in the ground. If Smokey should miss him, or an angel don't kiss him, then the devil might get him, cause he is hellbound. He went into hijacking with his fifth wheel a-backing. To hook into some booze was a breeze. With his hot cargo rolling, though silence is golden, somebody had called the police. In a bar in Juarez, a gal named Inez was waiting for Eagle at night. But how could she know in the dawn's early glow that the Eagle was on his last flight? There's an old gear jammer putting down his last hammer, headed straight for the slammer or a hole. As he drove through the night, payday was in sight. 2 hours and his trip would be done. It was his last load over Smuggler's Road. He'd soon see his Mexican son.
Anyways, well, he knew they were thank there. You guys very much for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Make sure to like and subscribe and leave a comment down below. And remember, hard times don't last, hard choices do. It's not about how much you make, it's about how much you keep. Fast food, fast trucks, fast women will get you in trouble. And last, but definitely not least, stay smooth, my friends.